Guardia Media. Of course, Miss Dragonstone, the house is clean, the drinks are plenty, and your jewelry is false.
Very well, Amelia, very well. I want everything to be perfect. This is going to be the most amazing party I've ever thrown.
And everyone knows what the wonderful hosts you are. Everybody loves your parties.
Thank you, Amelia. My parties wouldn't be so successful if I couldn't be too happy. You're truly a loyal housekeeper and friend.
Thank you, Mrs. Dragonstone.
Is that the door, babe? The first guest must be here.
I will get the door, miss.
Mr. Tramon Elliot is here.
Dear Marjorie, I'm delighted to be here again. It's so nice to see you.
My dear Jonathan, it has been a long time. Make yourself at home. Would you like some wine?
A glass of wine sounds perfect.
Mrs. Virginia Higgins has arrived. My dearest Virginia, we haven't seen each other for ages. I'm so glad you made it.
Marjorie, I wouldn't miss your party for the world, you know. So how have you been?
Excuse me, Mrs. Raffenstone. Mr. Albert Stratford is here.
Good evening, everyone. I'm sorry, I'm a bit late, but the weather is just awful outside and something was difficult.
Can I take your coat, sir, and your hat?
You can take my coat, but I'm afraid you cannot take my hat, dear Amelia. I will feel incomplete without.
Now that everyone is here, help yourself to some drinks. Amelia, make sure everything is set in the kitchen.
Of course, Mrs. Raffenstone, I will make sure everything is perfect.
So, Marjorie, why don't you show us your huge collections of antiques and jewelry?
That sounds really interesting.
Have you bought anything new recently?
As a matter of fact, I have, but there is no need to hurry. I will show you everything soon. But first, a toast. To you, my friends. Thank you for being here tonight.
To you, to us. To another unforgettable evening.
So they saw that their collection is.
Of course, Amelia. Amelia does a great job in the house, you know. She looks after my jewelry very well.
The first exhibit is diamond tiara. It dates back to the 19th century and it belongs to the Princess of Denmark.
The Princess of Denmark? How and how come is yours now?
I got it at auction last year.
It must have cost a fortune.
It must be worth millions.
Oh yes, it is. But I really wanted it in my collection.
The next piece is this golden ring. It is a wall. It is an old family ring, and it belonged to Mrs. Raffenstone's great-grandmother.
Unique!
Wow! If anyone ever robs your house, Marjorie, they are going to be rich.
Wait till you see the last piece.
And this is Mrs. Raffenstone's dearest dress.
Everything is going great. This is going to be an amazing week.
Mrs. Raffenstone, there is someone at the door. They say they are here for Mrs. Higgins.
Yes, that must be
precious stones, sapphires and diamonds.
And when was the last time you saw it?
I saw it at the same time as everyone else did, at around 9 o'clock last night.
And what happened? And what happened then?
After that, I took the necklace back to the room where we did Mrs. Raffenstone's collection.
Very well. You will show me the room soon. And now, I want to know what each of you did after Amelia put the necklace back.
We didn't do much. We all gathered in the living room, had dinner, listened to music, and playing cards.
I see. Did anybody leave the house?
Nobody left the house, sir.
Nobody left the house. But somebody must have left the living room.
Well, we all left the living room. People want to use the bathroom from time to time, you know.
Or they need to make secret phone calls.
Enough of the issues, Jonathan. There is no reason to accuse each other, is there?
It is fine, Virginia. I don't mind. Our dear Jonathan amuses me.
All right. Let's take things from the beginning. Amelia, when did you find out that the necklace was gone?
I found out this morning when I went to the post and delivery. As I do at 9 o'clock every morning.
Uh-huh.
So someone must have taken it between 9 o'clock last night and 9 o'clock this morning.
I see.
You've not helped me much so far, Mr. Jones.
Be patient, please. I will be patient, please. I mean, Amelia, are you sure you put the necklace in its place?
I'm very sure, sir.
Okay. All right. Thank you. Mr. Elliot, I noticed that you have been accusing others a lot. First you suspected Amelia.
Well, Amelia is housekeeper. He's not rich. Maybe she found the perfect chance to make some money.
What do you mean?
I didn't do it. Jonathan, I trust my staff. They wouldn't steal from me.
Nobody accusing you, Amelia. I'm sure that Amelia is not blamed. After all, she's not the only one who needs the money.
What do you mean, Miss Higgins?
Well, we all know that Mr. Stratford owns a lot of money to people. He's not rich, and he's careless with money. I'm not accusing him, of course. I'm just saying.
Of course, I should have known.
It is true, and after Marjorie showed us her collection, Mr. Stratford went outside to make a secret phone call.
Who did you call?
I called my sister. She's sick, and I want to see if she was better.
It is true that you have owned money to people?
It is true, but I didn't see that necklace.
Well, you are the only one. Well, you are the only one here who is not rich as the others.
That makes me poor, not a thief. Jonathan drinks like a fish. Maybe he stole it and forgot about it. Why aren't we accusing him?
I don't need the money.
You are a collector of antiques. And I'm sure you want to have it in your collection.
I did not steal it.
I truly don't understand. Almost everyone here is rich, so there is no reason why would they do something like that.
Amelia, could you bring some wine, please?
And also, anyone? Why would anyone steal it from Marjorie? Almost everyone here loves her.
Well, not everyone.
What do you mean?
Oh, come on, Virginia. Don't pretend you know nothing. Everybody knows that the things between you and Marjorie is not very good scenes.
To what?
Oh, come on now, Albert. It's just being seen. Nothing ever.
I can stand the hypocrisy of all of you rich people. Everybody knows that you can stand Marjorie because you're jealous of her. She won the horse riding race last year and you came in second.
I was not thinking it was Marjorie who won and not someone stranger.
Oh, I don't believe you.
Enough! Mr. Stafford, thank you. Amelia, could you please show me the room where Mrs. Ruffingstone keeps her necklace and everything else?
Of course, sir. Come with me. A bit later.
Mrs. Ruffingstone, I am pleased to tell you I have solved the mystery.
You did? Did you find my necklace?
Not yet, but I know who who stole it.
Who?
As you said, Mr. As you said, you see, Amelia told me something that I didn't know before.
What did she tell you? Who stole it? Tell
us. As you say, somebody left the house. But you forgot to tell that somebody came in the house.
Who came in the house? I don't understand.
Wait a minute. Virginia's butler came last night.
This is ridiculous. That butler came because I have a girlfriend. Marjorie's present at home. What are you suggesting? That he came and stole the necklace?
No! I am not suggesting that. You gave it to him.
I did not steal it.
Virginia, why? I didn't understand.
I did not steal it.
Yes, you did. And it was clever. Nobody came in. It was clever. Nobody came in. Nobody went out. And the necklace was gone.
I will never steal it from Marjorie. Marjorie is my friend. Why would I do something like that?
I told you. I have already talked with your butler.
He's a liar. You're all liars.
I told him that I would not send him to prison if he told me the truth, and he told me. Mrs. Higgins, I am arresting you for the theft of the necklace.
Let it go. I want a lawyer.
You see, dear Jonathan, it's not the only people who have good money that steal.
Actually, most of the time, the ones who have got money are the ones who steal.